When it comes to doing performance testing, a common activity that comes to people's mind is doing load testing on a protocol level. With this approach, you send multiple requests simultaneously to a service and verify if that service is still performant. When your data service is performant, however, this doesn't necessarily ensure that the overall user experience is going to be received well. From a browser perspective, several factors such as the size of your files, the quality of your images, and even the number of third-party network calls can also impact the performance of your application in the client's browser. In short, your API might have responded already, but your browser has not rendered the response within the time that your user expects. As mentioned in our front-end and back-end performance testing video, you need to do both types of performance testing to get a holistic view of your application's overall performance. The K6 Browser module helps you automate tests from a browser perspective and collect front-end performance metrics as part of your existing K6 tests. With the browser module, you can mimic a specific user journey and find blind spots that can't really be detected on a protocol level. To use the K6 browser module, make sure that you are using K6 version 0.43 and above. Since K6 browser is bundled natively in this version, there is no need to install any additional libraries or extension. Be warned though that at the moment of making this video, K6 browser is still an experimental module, so there will be additional features and breaking changes that will be introduced. Always check out the documentation for up-to-date changes. To write your first script using K6 browser, you first need to import Chromium from K6 experimental browser. Next, let's create our default function and set up our browser process. To launch an instance of Chromium, you need to call chromium.launch. Note that K6 browser will first look for a local Chrome instance and if present, will launch Chrome instead as it will be the preferred browser. A few default arguments are included when launching a browser process, but you can override any of the arguments by passing in a parameter option. In this example, I'm passing in headless and setting the value to false because I want to see the actual browser launching. To see a full list of options that you can pass, check out our documentation guide. To open up a new page, you need to use browser.newpage. Next, let's visit this awesome web application. To visit this application, we need to call page.goto and pass in the URL. Page.goto is an asynchronous operation, so to wait for this operation to finish before proceeding to the next line of code, let's use the await keyword. You then need to add the async keyword in your default function to make sure that this works. Let's imagine then that we want to automate the browser action of adding items to your cart to see if there are any errors on the browser level that your users might encounter. Let's go ahead and grab the selector of this first item. Since the selector can return multiple elements, we will use an XPath expression to get just the first item. To interact with this selector, we need to use page.locator and pass in the XPath expression. Page.locator will return the given selector with strict mode on. The strict mode only allows selecting a single matching element and will throw an error if multiple matches are found. Next, we perform a click action. To update the quantity of the item, let's grab the selector of this option. To select a value, I'm going to use the select option method and pass in a specific value. The select option will select the option that matches the value I pass, which is 3. Let's go ahead and click the add to cart button. Finally, we need to check that we have added the correct items to our cart. Since K6 has a built-in check functionality, we can easily reuse that in our browser tests. Let's go ahead and import check from K6. Then we can add a check in our browser tests. In this particular example, I'm passing the page instance and then using the locator.isVisible method to check if the selectors for my cart item name and quantity are visible on the page. Finally, to close the page and the browser, let's add the following methods. Let's run this test by typing in the command K6 browser enable to true, followed by K6 run and the file name. You can see that the following actions we have added in our test script are being performed, and when it's finished, you get a summary of important browser performance metrics. The errors that you see from the log came from the web application and doesn't necessarily impact your test run. Now, the real strength of the browser module shines through when you adopt this hybrid approach to performance testing. A hybrid approach means that you generate most of your traffic via the protocol level while simultaneously having one or two virtual users on a browser level. This is more cost-effective and efficient because spinning up a lot of browsers can be quite resource-intensive. To see how this works, I will extend the browser test to include a protocol level test. Let's first import HTTP from K6/HTTP module. Next, I'm going to create another function which I'm going to name as protocol test just to make it easier to distinguish. Inside the function, I'm making a simple GET request to the web application and asserting that the status code is equivalent to 200. Let's go ahead and also add a name to our browser test function and call it browser test. To execute this simultaneously with my browser test, I can use scenarios. Let's set that up quickly. So I have created two scenarios, one for my browser and one for my protocol. For my browser scenario, I'm going to use the per VU iterations executor and use the default values of just one virtual user and one iteration. Then we wanted to execute the browser test function. For my protocol level test, I will use the constant VUs executor and just say that I want 20 virtual user to send requests for 30 seconds constantly. Let's rerun this test. As you can see, it's now executing the two scenarios simultaneously. The browser is launching as expected, and at the same time, requests are also being sent via the protocol level. When that's finished, you get a unified report of front-end and back-end performance metrics. The K6 browser module is showing off a lot of strengths already, from starting off as an extension to now becoming an experimental module. Browser automation should be an important part of your performance testing strategy, especially when working with web applications. As I've mentioned already, be warned that our API is still undergoing a lot of changes, so the code demonstration that you saw as part of this video might still evolve into something more awesome. So if you have any issues, if you have any questions, or any feature requests, raise it as part of our GitHub project and our team would be happy to help you.